Welcome you to this video session on foundation design. Project assignment for Skyfire Labs online course by Kamrul Islam, Assistant Professor, Rural Engineering College, Ulkoti. This video is made by Kamrul Islam of Rural Engineering College, Ulkoti, as a part of the final assignment of foundation design course from Skyfire Labs. The foundation design project online course video tutorials from Skyfire Labs was used to complete this project. Thank you very much Skyfire Labs for giving me a wonderful learning experience and exposure to software in structural engineering. Looking into the problem statement, here I will be analyzing and designing the mat foundation for a tall building in Bangalore city using SAFE software. This tall building is a building which was analyzed previously for time history, response spectrum and wind analysis. The same model is referred for the design of foundation. So here are the details of the model which was used earlier. So here the data required are mainly the safe bearing capacity. It is assumed as 300 kN per meter square, allowable settlement equal to 1 cm, subgrade modulus of soil that is given by SPC divided by allowable settlement that is equal to 3 × 10⁴ kN per meter cube, and column strip width is 0.25 times of the length that is 18 meter, so it is 4.5 meter. So now let's start with the SAFE software. So here in the Windows screen, click on SAFE software evaluation version, click on file, select new model, select the code in the design code as IS456. Here design preferences, click on that and click on this minimum cover slabs. According to IS456, minimum covering will be top covering is clear covering is 50 mm and bottom covering is 50 mm according to IS456, and prefer the bar size as 22 mm dia. Click OK. So here in units, click on modify or show units, select metric defaults, click OK. So here click on grid only option. So here in the coordinates select, we have 18 meter along breadth and along length we have 18 meter dimension, so total number of grid lines are 19 in x direction and 19 in y direction. Let me have the grid line spacing interval to be 1 meter. Okay, now I will be defining the materials. So here to define the materials, I will go with the ETAPS software to check in into the materials used. So here this was the previously analyzed model. For this model we are analyzing the and designing the mat foundation. So to check the materials, go to model. So here in the model you can find the materials used as M40 and mild HYSD 500. So here, and later I need to extract some of the values like size of the columns in the first floor. Here we have 16 columns from C1 to C16, and the sizes of the columns such as here, just by clicking on this you find the size of the column to be 500 by 500. If you check into some other columns like C4, C6, find the column size will be 800 by 800. So here I have two types of column sizes, that is 500 by 500 and 800 by 800. So that values I have been extracted in a separate Excel file. So here are the columns from C1 to C16 and the dimensions are 500 by 500 and one more column size is 800 by 800. And I need to find the dead loads and live loads for this column. So here this will be again extracted from the etabs file. So here in the etabs file, you go with the tables, you check into the analysis results, find these values by right clicking, click on show table. So the dialog enforces, you find right click on the storage, click on story 1 and click on the load case that I need dead load. So for dead load, check the station to be ascending. So here I have an Excel load of 1650 for column number 1 for that dead load. So here you find 1650 for, so likewise for other columns I have extracted the values. The same way, so you have to extract the values for live load just by changing this output to live. So you find this Excel force values from C1 to C16. Okay, so this is the things required from etabs. Now going to save. So here first to define, go to define menu, click on materials, select add new material, add a concrete material as M40, as what we used for the earlier model, use concrete. And here say change some data like weight will be 25, modulus elasticity let it be 31, and here these values are this, and concrete strength will be 40. Click OK. Now add new material for rebar, so that is HYHD 500. Click on rebar, take the load as 77, modulus of elasticity and grade strength minimum 500, the maximum tensile strength will be 445. Click OK. Click OK. So now define the slab properties. A new property, let me take slab 1. So here the material will be M40. So this mat foundation will be a slab type. So I can name this foundation type here, mat foundation. So here let me assume the thickness as 1200. Next click OK. Okay, now again go to define, select the column properties. So here we have two types of columns, C1 and C2. C1 say M40, size are 500 by 500. Click OK. Next add one more column size of 800 by 800. Okay. Now defining the load patterns. See here the loads are already by default available. Click OK and define the load cases. Even these are by default available. Click OK. Now defining the load combinations for add. Click in this dialog. Click on add new combo. Select the dead load factor as 1.5 for ultimate loads, and for live load add 1.5. select strength design selection for ultimate loads. Click OK. Add one more combo to select TED, scale factor will be 1, and select live scale factor will be 1. It is for service loads according to IS 456. Click OK. Now go to draw menu, select draw slab areas. So here select mat foundation slab area. So here click on this first node and join this point. Join splint. Now close this or escape. So now we have created the slabs. Now to draw the columns, so here we have the columns on this sides. So before that, go to draw, select draw dimension lines. Close to draw. Options, draw edges. Using offsets.